Hi guys, I'm Tom and welcome to Monday Motivation Episode 3. Today we're in the Rhodes Gym to find out more about the upper body exercises that you can do to sculpt that summer body. Let's go.
Just to make sure that the exercise is more effective, you're leaning back before you start executing the exercise, so you can start feeling execution just by leaning back. And this will be your starting position and this will be your ending position as well. So all you do is, obviously with your upper back straight, so the spine erect, contracting the abs, tilting your hips, pulling it basically up towards your face, so activating the core, and then you're pulling the weight back, inhale, and then exhale up, upwards, and you don't lock your elbows. So your elbows are slightly bent, and then your head straight, shoulders relaxed, pulling back so that you make sure that you're using as much as your upper back as possible. This is also for the upper back. I believe it's one of my own inventions as well. So I'm gonna make it a compound exercise where I also put a bit of the abs, but it's not as intense for the abs as it is for the upper back.
So Tony, I've noticed that you've been training us a lot of compound movements. What is the advantage of compound movements over isolation exercises?
I don't mean to sound arrogant now. Isolated exercises, for me, I believe it's a waste of time because I've done that for so many years and I haven't seen any progress in developing in terms of transformation of the body. The compound exercises you're working, for example, with the ab exercise. You're working different ab group exercises, also just working one at a time. So you can come in here with compound exercise, you can come in here and do three exercises and you'll be done, finished. And with the isolated exercise, you're coming in and you have eight exercises to do. I feel like you can do much more after having done three exercises, maybe going outside and doing a run and have more time like to have quality workout as opposed to coming in and doing quantity.
Okay, so
that's basically
quality over quantity.
Yeah. And you don't have to spend 12 weeks to transform your body. Maybe even 6 weeks, maybe half. That's what I've experienced with the people that I've worked with as well.
Fantastic.
Okay, so the next exercise is also an ab exercise, but it's also for your hip flexors. So again, a compound exercise.
Yeah.
Your hip flexors, your abdominals, lower abdominals, your glutes, and your hamstrings. Also your calves, because you're gonna the starting position is on the balls of your feet. Yeah. So basically, with this exercise, I believe that anyone can do it as well.
Great.
Okay. So the first thing is that you're leaning against the wall. Right. Okay, and with both legs and the balls of your feet. So your feet slide to one from the ball. Yeah. Yeah. So now, same thing, knees slightly bent, hips forward, tilting your pelvis up towards your face, contracting your abs, spine erect, your head up as well. Okay? Starting position, there. Yeah, so you keep with the driving knee. This is a driving knee. So whichever one is coming up is a driving knee. So you're going to make sure that your toes are pointed upwards.
Right, okay.
Okay? This format that I said, one, two, three, four, five, up to 10. Yeah?
Alright, great. That's it.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Alright, fantastic. Thank you so much, Antonio. It was great working with you today, and I know I'm sure learned a lot. I hope you did at home too.